Okay, this is Sam Smyth from Smyth Imports. This is Nelson Healey 3000. That's been sitting several years. That's 42,000, 69,000 original miles. It's idling at 1,000 RPMs. This is a factory overdrive car. It was an SSCA rally race car all over the place. You got Coney Island, June 1964, Alpine Rally, 64, sending some Concours, a lot of Kentucky stuff. Bluegrass Rally, Kentucky 1960. But anyway, getting back to the car itself, the overdrive's working good now. Everything seems to be working good. Temperature's at 190 in the dual water and oil gauge, and our oil pressure is over 40 hot. We've been letting it idle about 15, 20 minutes. We're trying to see if we can get any leaks out of the car or any problems from, you know, clamps, hoses receding in, expanding, contraction. We want to get everything nice and hot too, then turn it down and shut it off and make sure we don't, you know, we just don't want anything coming unglued on this car, so we're trying to do as much preventative maintenance as we can. But yeah, this has been a well-rally car. There's Road America Can-Am, Second Annual Bluegrass National Rally, Kentucky Regional SCCA, Slalom Series in 72. Wow. Anyway, it was brought into us, shipped in on a transport, and they asked us to get it started running. We've done so. We haven't made the car like brand new or anything, but we have it started running and driving, and it's turned out very nicely. We're going to put together a report to the owners of things that they should do. Right now, I'm going to turn this over to Jeremy, and he's going to take a walk around the car, let you listen to the engine run for a minute, so you can see what's going on. Fuel gauge is working. Everything's working nicely. There's that temperature gauge, still idling, and oil pressure real high. So here you go.
As it was mentioned before, this car had a factory original hardtop, which is very rare, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. Under the hood, as you can see, we record the radiator. It's got the factory original green paint it's supposed to have on the block and the silver on the intake. We went ahead and upgraded it, deleted the points out of it, and put the Pertronics electronic ignition in it. Keep in mind, this is a positive ground car, so it's a little bit more complicated than normal, but nonetheless, it was doable. We put a water pump on it, and the fan blades have been reconditioned. We have the European clamps throughout the cooling system. As you can tell, it's got factory original air cleaners on it. This car is running absolutely perfect. It's beautiful. We put the chrome Austin Healey valve cover. And she's whispering away.
Yeah, I like that new brake can bottle we put on there for the, we got the original curling sticker, original bottle. We were lucky to get that. Those original air cleaners, boy, that was great to get that. And then keep that all original. Of course, we have the low pressure cap too. That was nice to be able to get that original. Turned out really nice. You know, that wiring too, straightening up a little bit of the wiring on the car, making sure that would work and run and be reliable. Gas tank turned out really nice. It's got Cooper's original gas tank. Had that cleaned and lined and all done, which is, that's something that most people just throw them away and get rid of them. So we're kind of glad to try and keep as much as we can. That aluminum racing plant, and boy, that oil pan, that thing's totally awesome, isn't it? I mean, so then he can keep the original one, but that thing's just awesome. So anyway, that's Jeremy. I'm Sam Smyth. This is an Austin Healey 3000. It's a BT7. So if you need any work on a Healey 104, 6, 3000, overdrive, non-overdrive, or a Bug Eye Sprite, Austin Sprite, or anything, please give us a call in Cincinnati, Ohio, 513-793-0434, or visit our website at Smyth, S-M-Y-T-H, Imports, I-M-P-O-R-T-S.com. Thank you.